that the citizens of Ruleville to let a damn Mexican,
I'm recording you on it right here, bro.
Oh, it's cool to let a Mexican restaurant come in a city that's almost all black. Now, you look at all the black people in Ruleville, they spend their money with the Mexican restaurant. They go to Cleveland, spend it with Little China. They spend it with Double Quick, which is owned by Thomas Grisham. They spend it with Piggly Wiggly. They spend their money with all them people. Got an Arab gas station across the street.
Arab.
You wonder why we broke.
You know why? You know why? I boycotted the Arab gas station also, too. I boycotted them last year by social media because a little guy was in front of me. He asked me, how you start your business, sir? How you start your business? He asked me who business it was first. It's my own. He said, how you do? I said, man, started out with man. But I had faith in God and dream and $100. And right. I worked for it. And I said, I didn't have to go to no bank. I didn't have to get funded. None of that. Just believing in God and just hard work. Then he's like, man, that's so amazing. And so I said, man, black people, we got so much powerful, man, and knowledge, man, to a point where they try to block that out of us. They think, you know what I'm saying, all the other people, they get these big loans and all that from the bank and all that.
That's right.
And they know that dude told me, hey, you can't talk about that in my store. I said, what you mean I can't talk about that in your store? He said, oh, well, be quiet. And I said, look, you going to remember this face. And I posted on Facebook, and all these people telling me about the same stuff they were going through with the Arab stores.
Yeah, because they don't want us to know about economics. That's why I don't agree. Public education teach us to go to school and work for them. The dude who owns Facebook, the dude, Bill Gates, the dude come up with the iPhone, Facebook, and the internet are the three major things, the controlling powers of the world. These three dudes dropped out of college. They got people with PhDs and bachelor degrees working for them. So when we talk about business and economics, I can put one out there right now. People finna get their refund checks. Why would you go get an income tax check for $9,000, go put $3,000 down on a car, and then have a $500 money note? Well, you must don't know business, and they don't want you to know business, because is this your first time ever buying a house? You can go to the bank and buy a house that's worth $100,000. I only pay 3%. That's $3,000. So when you get your income tax, you can go to the bank or go to Joy Federal Credit Union or go to Baxter's and say you want to get you a house built from the ground up. They're going to say, this your first house? You say, yeah, how much it cost? Let's say it costs $15,000. $150,000. If to get a $150,000 house built, all you need to do is put a $4,500 down payment on it. So when you see these people standing in front of these $200,000 houses, talking about, I bought me a house. No, they ain't about their house. It's just like if your car costs $30,000, you don't pay $30,000 for it. You pay $2,000 or $3,000 down and you get it off the driveway, off the lot end with a note. Same with a house. So we can take these $4,000, get a $100,000 house bill with a $500 note. That's the same as a car, but we got a house. A car depreciates in value when you carry it off the lot.
The house raised
up in value.
That's right.
Which means if you ever get poor and broken, you don't got no money.
But you got an asset.
You got some equity. Refinance your house. Get some money. Buy you one of these little $15,000 house that you can charge $400 or $500 of rent for, and let that $400 or $500 house pay for that $200,000 loan you done.
Man, I'm glad I met you, brother.
Dude, without this knowledge, we going to school, got a bachelor's degree and a master's degree in social work. Man, you got dudes graduating.
All these degrees.
I got a bachelor's degree. I'm like, bro, what's your bachelor's degree? This dude got a bachelor's degree in massaging football player thighs and thinking he's smart. While you got the Asians and the Chinese and a white American going to school for mathematics, science, philosophy, we losing down here. But here go the key. Rosedale got 1,700 black people, 60 white people, and 6 Chinese. The 6 Chinese own more business than the 1,700 white people. Than the 1,700 black people. With 1,700 black people, you got a white judge, Judge Strace, a white mayor, and a white lawyer. This is my knowledge to them. If this town has 1,700 white people and 60 black people, do you think them 1,700 white people elect them have a black judge, a black mayor, a black lawyer for the town? And do you think them 1,700 white people elect 3 Chinese's come and own the only liquor store and 3 other stores and let the other 2 or 4 black people come from out of town and control business in their neighborhood? That if we know they won't let that happen to them, why are we letting it happen to us?
Hey, and guess what? Ruleville, the same way, 90% black town, bro, ran by a racist judge that just don't matter what happened, you're guilty. These people living in poverty don't have the money to fight this injustice. They just let it be. And anybody that stand against them, they try to scare with fear, like me. So I've been trying to get people elected to go to board meetings and everything. You got one white man down there, Billy Marlowe, run the whole city. The mayor just sit on the sideline and just ride around in the truck and make sure the town clean. Why this one guy that's on the board of aldermen is running this whole city, controlling everything. Like me, they tried to arrest me later. They took me in for a back fine. Yeah. They made me pay that money because I went live on them, telling everybody about what's going on. But they deal with us. The kid used to get donations for like their football team at the 4-way stop. When the Mexican restaurant opened up, They stopped the kid from doing that. Okay,
I heard that.
That's me. That's right. Okay, Greg Bills got a body shop down there. Once Greg Bill started working on cars, my brother is a known mechanic. He works for Cannon right now. He's working on cars in the yard. They stopped him when Greg Bill started working on cars. They stopped him and another guy named Archibald. Yeah, did working on cars. Yeah. Okay. And they started, so okay, that happened. Okay, the Mexican restaurant bought this. The other lady named Jackie. Jackie Hughes. She we do Christmas, like this year, we're going to do a Christmas drive for the kids. We do back to school drives for them and all this. We do a lot for the community. The Mexican restaurant don't do nothing for our community.
That's
but
right.
That black lady, they stopped her from cooking right there by the Mexican restaurant. When that Mexican restaurant opened up, they stopped her from cooking, talking about city orders. And then what they been doing to us, they talking about city orders. Like, we own like two clubs downtown. Three clubs in the liquor store down there. So, on when Ruville Roast had the Ruville Roast down there, we was cooking in front of our business. And they came over there and told us we couldn't cook in front of our business unless we was in part of Ruville Roast. That Ruville Roast for the white people. So the Ruville Roast, they didn't go through any kind of permits or anything to have Ruville Roast. So how in the world we got to go all this in front of our own business? So they try to make us leave and everything from right there. You know, so they want to control the black people, tell them what they can and not do. But only I had went to a city board meeting and made them reveal the city orders, because by law, the attorney general state that every city got to provide the city order to all citizens at all time to see. They wasn't even providing us with this information. When they finally did it, the chief of police couldn't show me any book where I got to close my club down at a certain time. We can't ride. He couldn't show me none of this.
That's right. So which means they make it unconstitutional. And if it make it unconstitutional, and anybody that's a public servant, that's all the city councilman is, a public servant. So that means they here to serve the public. We're not here to serve them.
That's right. Correct.
So in other words, if they hit a move on you that's unconstitutional and they took an oath to protect the Constitution, that's a lawsuit that you can get among that city, because what it is, it's showing favoritism and it's showing bias towards one another, because these same people that's on, I guarantee y'all don't even know them, but I guarantee you they probably, some of them were born between 1950 and 1965. That means they probably 60 to 70 some years old. They was born in 1964. That means when Fannie Lou Hamer was over there in Ruleville pushing for the democratic process, and she was over there getting jailed, beat by the white police, it was them people right there that was kids that didn't know what was going on. Now they want to run the town, but don't know nothing about the town. So we got the same problem here. We got six Chineses. The only liquor store is a Chinese store. When we get a Chinese that money, that Chinese send it to whatever they're
right.
doing it. The point is, all the money we giving these people, they are not giving none back.
Nothing back.
A double quick don't give a dime back to the city. Won't even let you hang a PTO poster.
That's right. They won't let me put my business sign right there.
Right. So I just left double quick right there. They just hit the lot. The people just came over with the lottery today buying tickets. These people in Rosedale won't even get a basket and put money in it. But now I just seen since this morning around $3,000 to $4,000 getting spent almost probably on lottery tickets today. On lottery tickets, but y'all broke. Y'all can't put this money in the basket to create this business. So what happened is, this is one dude named Jack Colby. This dude got most of all the business through downtown, painting them, fabricating them aside like he really gonna do something. The people are like, yeah, we just want to see people to come in and do something for Rosedale. Well, what if I bring 100 Chinese and let Chinese come and build up in your neighborhood? That's not our neighborhood. Until we own the businesses, till we control the politics, till we control the agricultural land, then it's our community. Brother, it's just like this. I'm coming and living in your house. Everything in the house is yours, but I'm calling it my house. That's not my house. I'm living in your house. It's only my house that I own some stuff up in there and I can do for myself. Until then, we can't do for each other. It's game over with.
Yeah, right, bro.
It's game over with. So now you're wondering why you got the levy over there. People working at Jan Tran can't do nothing. All they can do is get money. And when you get the money, who you going to buy your vegetables from? Who you going to buy your gas from? Who you buying your clothes and shoes from? Anytime I go to Cleveland, you can go to No Way Jose. That's a Mexican restaurant. You will never see a Chinese in a Mexican restaurant. You go to Little China, you will never see the Mexicans in a Chinese restaurant. But you, one person you will see in each one of them restaurants is black people. But build an African restaurant, you will never see a Chinese or a Mexican come up in there. So once again, we've been duped. Because we don't produce nothing. So we kind of like, if we don't come together by any means necessary, game over with.
Yeah.
Game over with. And now we leaving this fight up to these little kids. These little kids,
exactly.
Around, they don't know,
man,
nothing about
history, tell
politics, or nothing.
Man, that's why I tell
so
these.
So this is the fight we living into.
That's why I tell them, man, why would we want to put this fight into our kids? Our kids, you see what these folks doing? Why we want to put this fight into our kids? We got to fight right now. Got to make a movement. Unity. See, unity got to happen. People got to come together, man. They got to come together, number one.
That's right.
And that's what we've been working on. I'm working on, man. Ever since I've been doing it, I've been harassed. I done been, man, I was right in front of you right now. The chief pulled me. I went to double quick to render aid. Somebody had ran into the store. I go there. I got constructors coming. I spend money with them all the time, so I go render aid. They got all smart with me and stuff and all that. I said, all the money I spend right here, y'all, they done called the police over there. I'm in my truck, finna get in my truck. Chief come over, hey, I miss your ID. What's called? I got the video of it and everything.
Who the chief over there?
The chief is Ernest Scarborough, the guy that shot himself in the chest.
Well, tell Ernest this. If a police come to you asking you to see your ID, that's unconstitutional. You don't got to present ID or identify yourself to nobody.
I ain't breaking no law.
Until you committed a crime. If you did commit a crime in the progress of committing a crime or submitted to committing a crime, you don't need to identify yourself to nobody. And the next time he come to you asking you for ID, you look at him and say, give me your name and badge number. And if he don't give you his name and badge number, once again, he's unconstitutional, broke the law. And that's another lawsuit because they are public servants. They are here to serve us.
Correct.
We're not here to serve them. See, once you know the Constitution, you saw it. Anything, for instance, there's no such thing as traffic court. The Constitution says the only time you got to present your ID to any public servant is when you broke a law, in the progress of breaking the law, or suspicious. If you run a stop sign, that's not a law. That's a violation. That's an infraction. So if you run a stop sign, the police come to your car and say, show me your license. The only thing you got to ask them is, what crime did I commit? And if you didn't commit no crime, running a stop sign is not a crime. That's an infraction or a violation. A crime must have an injured party. So if I punch you, then I committed a crime because you the injured party. Now we got a plaintiff and a defendant. So when the police, if I run a green light and run a red light and the police say, where your ID? I say, sir, I don't got to show you my ID right now because I ain't commit no crime. Now he the one that took an oath saying he gonna protect the Constitution and protect me under the Constitution. So Correct. All I'm doing is giving him the Constitution, saying, look, this what you got to protect. And this paper said that if I ain't commit no crime, I don't got to identify myself to you at all. So it's ain't nothing but a trick. Traffic court ain't nothing but a trick. We under common law jurisdiction. You understand? So if they say you parked in a handicap spot, they say, well, that's a fine. You trying to get my money, but I ain't commit no crime. If I didn't commit no crime, I don't need to even see a police officer. In other words, go on about your business and go handle your duty. Don't try to exploit or extort me by the police not knowing the law and the Constitution. It opens wide up for lawsuits. I don't really want to sue the town like this because they already don't got nothing. I'd rather educate the people. I'd rather educate the police officer. Man, look, you got dudes who been playing sports and doing things like that their whole life. Life ain't working out. They try to work at Baxter's. Stuff don't work out. They try to do this, it don't work out. They say, you know what? All I got to do is go to a camp for 12 weeks. And I can walk around calling myself the law with a gun? How you call yourself the law and don't know nothing about the law? How can you protect the law if you don't know the law? So I just want the police to get educated to understand that y'all job is more than what you think it is. You really here to serve and protect the people. But however, I don't understand how their job get hard, though, brother. I can really see how they job can get hard and how people make it hard. But that's why I say it's for the people of the community to take over. Ruleville should not have no Mexican restaurant in that city. Just like Rosedale should have half of the stuff we got up here if it ain't hardly black owned. And it's nothing dealing with prejudice or nothing like that either, bro. It's just, all I'm saying is that if Ruleville 90% black, they should control 90% of the business. If Rosedale 90% black, we should control 90% some of the business.
Yeah, right.
It only makes sense.
Yep.
It only makes sense.
The majority.
Yeah, the majority should control the majority of the business. Anything else, it raises things of exploitation. Brother, we've been so fooled. You got people around here talking about I graduated from Valley State University. Did you know Valley State is a historically black college university, supposed to be an HBCU? How is Valley State a HBCU and the founder from Rosedale, the white man Walter Sillars? He founded, that's why, and you go to Cleveland right now, you see the Walter Sillars Coliseum. That dude, he was the House Speaker for the Mississippi government, one of the most vicious, hypocritical, racist politicians there ever was to step a foot in Mississippi. Mm. He was cool with James O. Eastland, straight out of Ruleville. That's where the Eastland Plantation is. Man, you got people in Ruleville. As soon as Nixon got shot, you got people in Ruleville kicking it with the president Lyndon B. Johnson. So what I'm trying to get people to see is that if white people started the NAACP, then they put Martin Luther King in their face on it. White people started Valley, then they call it a historical black college university. A white man started Alcorn.
They infiltrating black people. Infiltrating us.
You see, no, what it was.
It's like the Ruleville Hospital right now, they got all the black people on all the video. Take me to Ruleville. Take me to Ruleville. Take
it?
Me to Ruleville. They
look in the management. And now if you look at the top echelon of the Ruleville company, you gonna hardly see your people there. You understand? But my point is this. What about Delta State, Ole Miss, Mississippi, and the Southern Miss? If you look at Valley State, Alcorn, and Cahoma, these colleges are mostly for black people, and they're in the middle of cotton and rice and beans field. But then you go look at Delta State, Ole Miss, Mississippi State, and Southern Miss, they're in the middle of thriving cities. The only reason why Walter Sellers and them built the JUCO college was to keep us out of their colleges. This stuff is in history books. Mississippi was the first people who ever came up with junior colleges. It only makes sense. They didn't want us in their school, so it was never called Valley University. It was a vocational center. And when they seen that the black people went inside of Ole Miss and Delta State, get what they did, they say, we're going to change this from a vocational center to a university, make a black president over, and watch all of them flock. Now look what's going on to this day.
Infiltrate the blacks, what they always do.
They infiltrate our minds, and what I'm trying to get people to see, black, if all the black people stop playing NFL, there's no more NFL. All the black people stop playing NBA, there's no more NBA because it's nothing exciting. Black, we are the best in sports. We are the best in math. We are the best in science because we're the one who invented the math. But everything you put us in, we're the best. And what I'm trying to tell the people now, if everything we do, we the best, let's get into the thinking field, the critical thinking field, and show people how to run the world. It's so easy. But long as we don't understand our history and all we think about is slavery, we never understand what we really.
That's what they do. That's why I say about the school. See what I say about the school. Look, the school they put here, they really traumatizing these kids from the damn start with all this hanging in school. Like we was in school, you getting hanging and all these and moves in school. You traumatizing them. My history, you making them scared of the master from the door.
That's right.
That's what you're doing in the public school.
Look, they never tell them this. In math, they say Pythagoras is the father of mathematics. He came up with something called the Pythagoras theorem, which means you can't build a square pyramid with this theorem. Well, what about 2,000 to 4,000 years before he was born, a square pyramid was already in Egypt? How do I need his formula to build a square pyramid, and the square pyramid was built 2,000 years before he was born? That's a lie. You look at the father of medicine. They call him Hippocrates. I pulled up the Hippocrates script. Hippocrates said this. He said that he studied medicine in Egypt. He said that he learned all his knowledge from Egypt. You go look at Socrates and Plato and Aristotle, the great Greek philosophers. They spent 15 years studying in Egypt. And when you go look at what they wrote, they said the people in Africa taught them everything they know. So we taught them. Right now in Memphis, Tennessee, it's a place called Memphis, Tennessee. Socrates and them, they went to this place called Memphis, Egypt. It was the most civilized area in the land where the most of commerce and it never flooded. And it was the center of commerce and education. You look at Memphis, Tennessee right now, it never flooded. It got the pyramid down there, which the pyramid come from Africa. Memphis, Tennessee literally come from the name of Memphis, Egypt. One of the greatest civilizations that didn't even flood, which came from our brother Imhotep. Without us understanding this, we say, hold on, how y'all say Socrates is the Greek philosopher and he went and studied 15 years in Africa? How is this dude called the father of medicine and he went and studied for 15 years in Africa? And then they said that these people in Africa are the true gods. The people that we call the father of medicine, science, and all that call our people in Africa the true gods, and we don't even know that we came up with our history. The first pyramids were built in the center of the earth. They still don't know how they get built. They still don't know how they put 60,000 pounds blocks over the desert to get them to build this pyramid. They still trying to figure out how we did it. They the ones up in Africa digging 4,000 feet down in the ground, taking up big old tombs that we preserved the body in and crusted in silver, diamonds, and gold. That came from our people. That came from Egypt. People don't even know Egypt is in Africa. That's how blinded they are. So I want to sue Mississippi Department of Education for not teaching me my accurate history. And without teaching me my history, I can't love myself. And when I can't love myself, I can't love nobody else. And that's an increase in black-on-black violence. It started in the school miseducating our kids, man. Making them look at white as superior. We live in America, right, which is a white racist system. It got built off racism. The greatest force for black people is white supremacy. People don't like admitting it. I like saying it. I got in front of my yard. I caught some kids walking, brother. I asked them kids four or five questions. I said, what color Jesus? They said white. I said, what color God? They said white. What color the angels? White. What color you? Black. If Jesus white and the angels white and God white, obviously white gotta be good or bad. They say good. I say, what color are you? They say black. I say, what color you wanna be? They said white. Kids. That's exactly what they said. And these kids is straight up in fifth and sixth grade kids. I ain't asking no other questions but that. It show you what the mind they think right now, because I'm messing with their psyche. I ain't trying to persuade them to say nothing. I just asked them some questions. And they told me all that. But people don't understand their history. I can say bitch right now, people gonna think about a woman. They won't think about a female dog. I can say, look at that heifer. They'll think I'm talking about a woman. They won't know I'm talking about a female cow. So when people read the Bible, when they say Mary was a virgin, if you don't know the true definition of a virgin, you're gonna think virgin means not having sex. So if I see a woman and a dog walking, I say, golly, look at that bitch. Somebody who don't know the definition of a bitch gonna think I'm talking about that woman, but I'm using proper terms, so I'm talking about the dog. So when I say Mary was a virgin, you think in this day, virgin means not having sex. I mean, virgin means, yes, not having sex. But in the biblical days, back in B.C., when they say you are a virgin, that means you are not married. Mary was a virgin. Of course she was a virgin. She wasn't married. But virgin don't mean not having sex in that time. If you don't know your vocabulary, they'll trick you with words. They'll use trickery logic to trick and deceive and manipulate. If you go look in the old dictionary, right, way before Westwood, look at the definition of black. Black means gleaming, shining, whitening. That means when a person real black, they almost look like they got gold in them. They gleaming, shining, bright, white. That what black mean. Bright, white, gleaming, shiny. But you go look in the Bible, they're going to describe King Dirty. Solomon. You see, they're going to put him in a description. Well, if you don't know the true definition of black, you'll think that mean white. That's why I don't agree with American education, because they didn't teach me none of this. It took me for the past 2 or 3 years to start going through this, brother. That's when I was finally thought I found some people on Facebook. Come to find out, it's on the very few. It's on the very few people that got your back in Roomville. I was looking at it, brother. Like, who getting this man back? We talking about all this? Hardly nobody. But they don't understand how much them Mexican people making. And they don't understand where their money going at. Man, we African. We eat French toast. We eat French fries. If we cuss, we say, excuse our French. We go to the Mardi Gras. We go to the French Quarter. We ain't French. We black. And that's what I'm saying. And that's what we're going to have to start doing. And I just call that black nationalism. When whatever you think you do, if you're going to go be a scientist, you need to be trying to figure out some scientists for the black people, for your people. And that, it's not wrong with that. Because when the Arabs pass their store down to another Arab, and they pass their store down to another Arab, that's called Arabian nationalism. When a Chinese come in and they get turn their business over to another Chinese, and they turn their business over to another Chinese, that's called Chinese nationalism. You can't blame them for turning their business over to their people. But what I'm trying to say, when black people got to start having something, and we got to start doing for ourselves and turn over our business to our own people, and that's called black nationalism. And it's only right. The Chinese got a Chinese God. The Europeans got a European God. The African people, the only one that don't got their God. The Chinese got a Chinese language. Europeans speak English. Japanese speak Japanese. The African people, the only one that don't got their language. See, we are the only people. For some reason, the Mexicans come to Mississippi, no matter where they go, they eat burritos and rice. Chinese go anywhere in the world, they eat sushi and fish. Black people, wherever they go, we trying to eat what they eat. We want to eat our steak dripping with blood. See, we don't have a knowledge of ourselves, and without a knowledge of ourselves, we can't love ourselves, we can't love our own brother. We end up respecting other people and killing off our own people. That's how black-on-black crime start. It start with a sort of miseducation. People think they've been educated, they've been miseducated. It's just like a fraction. You got two type of fraction, a proper and an improper fraction. You got two type of people that's educated. You got this brother who's educated and this person who's miseducated, but both of them educated. And without that brother, man, something gonna have to happen.
That's right.
Zach, something gonna have to happen, brother, because we leaving this fight to our kids, and our kids ain't finna. Man, our kids growing up wearing tight pants, and they don't care about nothing right now, yep. Man. Because they don't really got the true leaders. You know, I ain't really had no true leaders. Like I said, the people supposed to lead me, they gone right now.
Man, this man speaking number truth, y'all.
They gone.
Man, find me on. I'm up here. I'm at him Rosedale up here.
Yeah, when I see
you, Rosedale, man. They got me following me on Facebook. I ain't know who he was. So right here, Rosedale, right here, man. And that's how the conversation came about. You know, I just told him just last night. You know, I went paid on. I'm show y'all something right quick. How these folks?